So let's talk about it with Ian Pryor, Communications Director for American Crossroads. Brad Gerstmann is a Democratic strategist, also founding partner of Gotham Government Relations. Welcome to both of you. Ian, what do you think about those two responses?
Sure. Well, look, I think if you look at Hillary Clinton's statement, it's more of the same. Stay the course. We've got this under control. But that's not what the American people want to hear. And let's not forget that the Clinton-Obama policy is part of the reason why the world is on fire. It can be summed up in two words: weakness and confusion. And if you look at Syria, you look at Libya, and you look at Iraq, our policies there have created a vacuum which has allowed ISIS to take root. So is anyone really confident that that statement by Hillary Clinton shows that she's learned anything over the intervening 4 years from when she left the State Department? Because it looks to be the same as usual from Hillary Clinton.
Brad, the response from Donald Trump seemed to be characteristically tough, but not exactly full of specifics.
Well, that's exactly it. There aren't any specifics because he really doesn't have the specifics. But I do give him credit because he's appealing to those who are very interested in a more muscular foreign approach to our business overseas and to terrorism. And in addition, he's opening up that discussion. So, you know, I'm not from a political standpoint, I think he's doing the right thing because he's laying the groundwork to make a real decision. The American people at least need to make a real decision between a more muscular approach or, you know, more of the same. I don't terribly disagree with, you know, what was stated earlier. But I do think that if you look at the most recent poll and you see the questions were, is who do you feel would be more responsible in fighting terrorism, Hillary, I believe, had a double-digit lead over Donald Trump. So I'm not sure that Donald Trump's message is resonating as much as many people think it is.
All right, Ian, so let's imagine a President Hillary Clinton or a President Trump responding to what happened in Turkey last night. How do they go about it?
Sure. Well, you know, I think the Benghazi report that was issued yesterday was very instructive on Hillary Clinton. You know, we had a rescue team on the tarmac in Spain ready to go to Benghazi, and Hillary Clinton and her band of dithering bureaucrats were in a conference room worrying about what the rescue team should wear so as not to offend the Libyans during the rescue, at the same time that our embassy was under attack. Now, as far as what a President Trump would look like, well, you know, it's unclear, but what is clear, it's not President Hillary Clinton, so it's not going to be more of the same. I think it would be a more muscular approach. I think it would be a more aggressive approach, and I think that is the upshot of Donald Trump's foreign policy, is that we need to be more aggressive, we need to be more muscular, and it can't be the same policies that have led us down this dark path where ISIS has become an international force.
Yeah, Brad, one of the interesting conclusions of this Benghazi report is that, you know, people at the State Department messed up. There are lots of people who messed up, but, you know, the headlines all scream that there is nothing new correlating all of this to Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, exactly. This is, look, the Benghazi situation is, although of course I don't condone it, I think the behavior by government could have been much, much better. But on the other hand, it really doesn't have any connection to what's going on with international terrorism. Keep in mind, some of the attacks here in the United States are lone wolf attacks. They aren't as coordinated as they were in Istanbul at the airport. So we have to find out, how can we protect our own people? That's really the issue. And what is most affecting our country in relation to terrorism? And so I'd like to hear more specifics on that issue. Trump's offering none other than to bomb the heck out of those people over there, and you know, a lot of people like to hear that, and maybe that just opens a discussion and broadens a discussion, and if that's so, that's terrific as well. But you know, something a lot of people like, the Hillary Clinton and Obama path, despite what you may hear from others on the other side.
But I mean, what about the fact that they didn't want to offend the Libyan government, you know, and the dithering, as Ian put it, over the wearing of uniforms because they didn't want it to appear like there was some kind of an American invasion? Since when do Americans worry about offending other governments when American people are, you know, in harm's way?
You know what? I think the bigger question is, should the Democrats be concerned about these kind of issues as much as they may have been in the last 7 years? And I would agree that Democrats do have to take a step up in this fight against terrorism and be less apologetic and to move forward in a little more of an aggressive way. So, yeah, I think that mentality has to be tweaked. Again, the conduct with regard to Benghazi and all that stuff, you know, makes no sense to me, and it makes no sense to the public either. But I think the Democrats need to tweak that a bit. But, you know, the question becomes, again, there is a huge difference, there's a huge gap and a huge divide between Hillary Clinton's discussion on terrorism and Donald Trump's discussion on terrorism, and it's going to be up to the American people to decide which one they like more.
Yeah, so Ian, in a word, will voters keep in mind these responses, you know, to events like Turkey when they go to the voting booth?
Oh, absolutely. Look, this is going to be top of mind come November, and I think Americans want to see that, hey, look, we're at war with ISIS. We need to prosecute that war as it should be, not as a politically correct PR campaign, which is what it seems like the Obama administration has done for the past several years.
Ian Pryor from American Crossroads, Brad Gerstmann from Gotham Government Relations. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Still to come, Nike.